Hi, my name is Riley Clemens, and I'm not a morning person. I never will be. That's not my calling. You need to know anything about me. You need to know that I have my first cup of coffee by myself, away from everything. That's what starts the day. I would say I am a afternoon start to a right kind of girl. And normally I walk into the studio with an idea. I keep this beautiful section on my phone where I have all of my ideas. I can't tell you where it is because it's very secretive. It's in my notes section. It's not that secretive, but I do keep a lot of ideas in there. It's like this little box that I constantly have something to take into the studio. Growing up, I remember my first exposure to music ever was my mom singing in church. She was in the choir. I remember watching her get ready to sing and sitting on the edge of her bathtub as a little girl and listening to her warm up her voice and then going and watching the energy of the Southern Gospel Choir at church. And that was the initial draw to music. My senior year of high school got really busy and I would have a work study and sneak off to the studio and write with incredible producers and writers who've been in the industry for years and years. And that's the foundational time that I started learning what it meant to craft a song with people who are really good at it.
I can't tell you how many hours I've spent in this room over the past few months. It's the best.
It's true that sitting down to write Godsend was like a weight lifted off my shoulders for so many reasons. One, I had the title Godsend sitting in my phone for a long time at that point. I knew that that was a title of a song I wanted to write. I didn't know how to write it yet. And so I didn't want to take it in until I knew how to craft it, until I knew what it should be. And so sitting on the floor of my bedroom at my old keyboard that I've had since the sixth grade, just finding the chords for the song and going, yeah, this is Godsend. Today is the day we're going to write this one. In the middle of global pandemic, wondering where in the world any sort of hope or promise or goodness or light could be. All I knew was to look to what I've seen before and take that inhale and exhale and go, you know what? Maybe every broken thing I've experienced is somehow, in some way, a godsend. And choosing to look at life in the broken places through that lens changes everything. Everything. It has for me. And that's what I hope people feel when they hear it.
And every closed door, every single sharp thorn, every answer that didn't make sense. What if maybe they were just teaching me to depend on your strength in the dark days? All my tears got me crying out to you again. What if maybe every broken place I've been was a godsend?
This is the first record where I ever sat in the room with the producer and said, I would like to hear different drum sounds there. Or let's experiment with how we're stacking the piano parts. And I was in that process and I knew that I wanted this record to sound like me. And it's hard to explain it in any other way, but I knew in my head what that sounded like. And so it was a lot of what I was listening to on the radio. It was a lot of experimenting and trying things that didn't work. And then trying things that did and that felt distinct and that felt personal. The session for Stuck Inside My Head, I was in the middle of coming out of a relationship where I was stuck. My head kept going back there. I knew it was no longer serving me. I knew it was no longer healthy for me. But I was stuck in that place. And I thought that was valid to write down. I know so many people get stuck after they exit a relationship or exit a friendship or whatever it is. There's this feeling of being stuck, longing for what used to exist. So that was the learning process. That was the growing. And I would say I wrote Headspace when I arrived at this place of more confidence, of planting my foot in the ground and saying, nope, you can't have my headspace. I have better things to think about than the past. I'm gonna think about this moment. I'm gonna think about growing. I'm gonna think about being the best version of who I can be. And so it was this story. I know so many people who have walked through that. And I wanted them to share in this story with me of being stuck somewhere and then deciding that that is no longer where you're gonna exist. You're gonna keep moving on. You're gonna decide that you control where your head goes and what you think about and what you spend your time doing. And so that was a really important moment on the record because that was important in my overall growth as a person as I wrote it. You can't have my-